professional. Things are gonna get better. Hey, good morning, everyone, and welcome to day 26 of the 30-day challenge. Well, we have 4 days left of this challenge, and I know we can push these last 4 days out, do it strong, finish strong, and do it as a team and do it together. So today we have a rest day from one of our challenges. We're taking a rest day from the Tone It Up challenge, and I will also be doing modified push-ups. I have a very bad shoulder, and yesterday it slid out of the socket. Not all the way, it slides out and gets stuck, so it is very sore. So I'm going to be doing some alternative push-ups today. I think I'm going to do like a one-arm push-up, something I never ever really do. But we'll see how it goes. So, are y'all ready to get started with today's workout? Let's find a wall. Go ahead and lean against the wall. Again, we are doing the wall sit for 4 minutes and 20 seconds. So I'm going to take my legs out a little bit further from the wall. Completely forgot. And I'm going to go ahead and start the timer. There we go. So I just want to say that, you know, sometimes when you have an injury, so like I really did hurt my shoulder yesterday. I actually hurt in high school doing gymnastics. And yesterday, I'm always very, very, very careful with it. Because what happens is it's never come fully out of the socket, but it will slide out of the socket and get stuck, right? I've had it happen lifting weights. I've had it happen just playing around. Yesterday it happened when I was sitting in the chair and I leaned over to plug my laptop in to the wall socket and it slid out and got stuck. So I was in pain. It hurts for a while. I thought I had to go to the emergency room. Because I couldn't figure out how to slide it back in. Usually I just kind of twist it back in. And so it is very sore today. And that is why I ended up doing one-arm push-ups, which was very, 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 very hard. I should have done something else. But I didn't give up and I wanted to press through. I say all of that to say sometimes you have to find modifications for different things. So instead of doing a full push-up and hurting my shoulder even more, I did the alternative, which was a one-arm push-up. Also, now, if you have bad knees, you know, I really do want you to modify the exercises. You know, you're doing squats. If it bothers your knees, don't go as low. You know, do mini squats. The action, again, is in the squeeze. As long as you stand up and you're squeezing, squeeze really hard. Squeeze your abs, squeeze your butt, squeeze your legs, squeeze it all. That's going to help a lot. The other thing is those jumping jacks, right? So I do the alternative jumping jacks for you, which is the step to the side and bring your arms up. And so do those instead of full jumping jacks or alternate between them, okay? So those are some alternatives you can do when you're doing and you have bad knees. So just be careful. Even with doing this squat challenge, sorry, the wall sit challenge, you know, as you can see, my legs are more in a diagonal, not so much parallel because of my knees. Again, if you need to, you can scoot up the wall, move my feet back some, and just be here. But if you touch your quads or your thighs, you'll see they're activated, okay? So that's the key. You want to make sure that they're activated. Again, if you need to take a break during any of the exercises I'm doing, please take a break. You know, you can always jump back in with us. We will be here for you and just keep pushing through. So I'm very excited because we are doing an arm challenge for December. So I hope you're ready for that. Uh-oh, something popped up on the screen. So I hope you're ready for that challenge. I'm excited. I had to pick between doing tricep dips or doing the arm challenge that we are going to be doing, which incorporates, I think, 4 or 5 different types of arm exercises. So I know you guys are going to be joining me for December 1st. We always start off the challenges very easy, so I know you'll at least start with me with getting started. So I'm excited about that, and I cannot wait for us to start. We're going to end the year off on a good note. We're going to end it off strong, exercising the new year out, and also exercising the new year in. Don't forget that. So we have 20 seconds left. We can do this. Let's push through. We got this. And we have 10, 9, 8, 7. Ooh, I'm off of my count. 4, 3, 2, 1. That's it. Stand up. So great job, everyone. So we're doing 10 of everything while we're standing. Let's go ahead and do our 10 jumping jacks for a warm-up. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So as you see, it is very hard for me to do jumping jacks with that shoulder. So that's okay. It's always an alternative. We're doing squats. Stand up. We're going to sit back when we squat, okay? Feet stay flat on the floor. Let's go. Down, up, one. Down, up, two. Sit back. Squeeze. That's four. And squeeze. Seven. Squeezing my abs, two. Eight. Nine. 10. Great job, everyone. Now we're going to go ahead and go on the floor. It's time to do our abs and our push-ups. So I'm actually going to go ahead and get the push-ups done and over with first. So there are some alternatives. I've been showing you guys how to do them. I will definitely be doing one of them today. So you can do these here where you just do that. You can take your arms out wide and go all the way down as far as you can. You can do it on your knees, like here, and go up and down, or on your toes, okay? So I'm being very careful with my shoulder today. So one of the things I am going to try and do is one-arm push-ups. Let's see. On my knees. Let's see how far I get. So everybody give me a position. And make sure your abs are tight and you're breathing out when you come up. Let's go down. That's one. Woo! That's two. These are not easy. Three. Four. Five. Five more. Six. Seven. Eight, nine, oh, I put my hand on the floor. Ugh. 10, wow, is all I can say. Whew, those are difficult, but I did it. So let's lay back, let's do our crunches. Take your feet out, take them up. Now take them on a diagonal, lower back stays on the floor. If you can't do it like this, bend your knees, okay? This is a little bit more pressure, so you have to concentrate to do it. Hand behind your head. We're doing 10. My elbow is going to be up because of my shoulder. My other elbow's down, though. So let's go up here. Breathe. That's one. Up, two. Up, three. Up, four. Breathe out. Squeeze your abs. Seven. Eight. Nine. And 10. Great job, everyone. Now for our obliques. Stay on your back. Just twist your legs to the side, like this. Hands behind your head. Again, don't pull on your neck. Don't do this. Don't pull. Pretend like there's a tennis ball between your chin and chest, and go up and breathe out. So we're working the obliques right here, okay? Go up, breathe out, that's two. Up, three. Breathe out, that's four. Five. Breathe out, six.
seven, eight, concentrate, nine, don't pull your neck, 10. Great job. Turn your legs the other way and let them go as far as they can go. 10 on this side, go up, squeeze here, 1, 2, 3. So you're breathing out, 4, 5. Breathe out, that's 7. We take a little pause at the top, 9 and 10. Great job.
Guess what? We are now finished with today's challenge. So, I just want to tell you, make sure you find me on social media. You can find me at Facebook, at Shibby Williams. You can find me at LBX Fitness on Twitter and on Pinterest and also on Instagram. On Instagram, it's LBX Fitness, just one word. Also, visit my website, www.leadingbyexample.us, and I will see y'all tomorrow. Have a great day. Bye, everyone. Keep pushing on.